Welcome back. In the previous 2-3 lectures, we have seen frequency domain specifications. Then specifically for the second order underdamped system, and also we have derived some of the formulae for the time frequency domain specifications. In today's lecture, we will develop the correlation between time domain specifications and frequency domain specifications. So we have seen different time domain specifications such as delay time, rise time, peak overshoot, settling time, and also damped frequency was one of the parameter. And now in frequency domain analysis, we have seen the specifications resonant peak, resonant frequency, bandwidth, gain margin, gain crossover frequency, phase crossover frequency, and typically for the second order system, these values are dependent on zeta, and the formulation was also done. So let us start developing the correlation between the two. Resonant peak MR and peak overshoot MP are the specifications related to damping factor zeta only. So they are dependent on zeta only, and they are related to the highest value of the response in the frequency domain and time domain respectively. So let me write it. They are the terms related to highest value of frequency response and time response respectively. And similarly, the terms omega r, that is resonant frequency, and omega d, damped frequency, are analogous terms. So let us develop the correlation between MR and MP and omega r and omega d, from which we can have certain comment on the correlation between time and frequency domain specifications. So we have MP is equal to e raised to minus pi zeta upon under root 1 minus zeta square, and MR equal to 1 upon 2 zeta under root 1 minus zeta square. So both are dependent on the zeta. So let us draw the plot of MP and MR with respect to zeta or versus zeta is as follows. So what you can do for various values of zeta, starting from 0 to 1, let us compute MP and MR, and then tabulate those values and draw a graph. I have done it at the back end, and it is as shown here. from this plot, what we can see, as zeta increases, MP decreases exponentially and also MR decreases. Now when zeta is equal to 0, MP is 1, but MR is infinity. So it is starting from the infinity and it is approaching to 1. It cannot go below 1, because when MR becomes 1, the response becomes flat and there is no peak in the response. So MR cannot be less than 1, and as zeta increases, MR falls least value to 1. And the value of MR is equal to 1 at zeta equal to 1 by root 2. So from the plot, we can say that MR is 1 at zeta equal to 1 by root 2, and MR does not exist for zeta greater than 1 by root 2. Hence, the correlation breaks down at zeta is equal to 1 by root 2. And what is the correlation? The correlation says that also it can be seen that as zeta increases, MR and MP decrease, they both decrease, but MR decreases with faster rate. So these are the two conclusions from the graph that gives the correlation. Similarly, now let us develop the correlation between omega r and omega t. We have omega r is equal to omega n into under root 1 minus 2 zeta square, and omega d is equal to omega n into under root 1 minus zeta square. So sketching these two functions with reference to zeta is not exactly possible, because omega n is also the parameter. So to cancel out the common parameter omega n, let us take their ratio. So omega r by omega d is nothing but under root 1 minus 2 zeta square upon under root 1 minus zeta square. So similar to the earlier, we can tabulate this for various values of zeta, and we can have a plot. The plot of omega r by omega d versus zeta is as shown below. So this is the graph. So when zeta is equal to 0, omega r by omega d becomes 1. And as zeta increases, this ratio decreases. That means as zeta increases, omega r as well as omega d both decreases. They are both decreasing. If you put here zeta, increasing zeta, omega d will decrease as well as omega r will decrease. Though both are decreasing, omega r is decreasing at faster rate. That is our first conclusion. So from the plot, it can be seen that as zeta increases, both omega r and omega d decrease. But omega r decreases at faster rate than omega d. And one more thing is that omega r does not exist for zeta greater than 1 by root 2. How? If you put here zeta equal to 1 by root 2, then this will be 2 into 1 by 2 is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0. So at zeta equal to 1 by root 2, there is no oscillation. And that is why the response is flat. There is no separate peak in the response. And if you increase zeta further, these terms become negative and omega r does not exist. That is why these frequency domain specifications, that is omega r and mr, exist for the underdamped systems with zeta less than 1 by root 2 only. If the zeta is more than 1 by root 2, the correlation breaks down and the this specification does not exist. So what I can say here, the correlation breaks down at zeta is equal to 1 by root 2. So in the series of 3 to 4 lectures, now we have covered all frequency domain specifications and their correlation, formulation, derivations. It is enough in this lecture. In next couple of lectures, we will solve the numerical examples on frequency domain specifications. Thank you.